Hi there folks, it's Jonathan Denwood from WP Tonic, and in this video I'm going to be talking about Kajabi. Kajabi is one of the most popular SaaS-based membership building platforms on the market at the present moment. It's got some great strengths, but it's got some things that you've got to be aware of when it comes to the different level of pricing plans that they offer. I'm going to go into all the dirt that you need to know. I'll be back in a few moments, folks. I'm coming back. I'm going to be talking about Kajabi in this video. I've also want to point out I've written an extensive article on the WP Tonic website that goes into a lot more detail. You'll find the link in the supporting video notes underneath this video. So let's go straight into it. So I'm just going to give a quick outline of what Kajabi is to those of you that might not know everything to do with Kajabi, and then I go into the main differences, in my opinion, about the different pricing plans that they offer. Now, Kajabi markets it itself as the all-embracing Swiss Army knife for somebody looking to build a membership website, a membership-based business in the e-learning space. Basically to host your quizzes, your written content, and your videos under one embracing umbrella, plus with powerful marketing functionality all built into one platform. Very persuasive argument is, in my opinion, if you're looking for a Swiss Army knife, is one of the leaders in these all-embracing solutions. I would say that it definitely is. Podio also is a great solution as well. So of these tools, these SaaS-based membership, SaaS-based products, I would definitely look either at Kajabi or Podio. Now, when it comes to Kajabi, its great strength is its interface design. It is polished. The actual documentation and videos training that Kajabi supplies is top notch. I would disagree with some of their key messaging saying that it's really, 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 really easy to use. That is really very dependent on your prior online experience, basically. There's a whole market of people that make a good living on setting up Kajabi websites for clients. If it was that easy, these consultants, implementers wouldn't be able to make a good living, would they? It also offered a level of marketing automation integration that platforms like WordPress a few years ago could not offer. That has drastically changed. Also, it came with a good website builder, page builder, which again, a couple of years ago, an open source system like WordPress could not offer you. This has also changed. But in the kind of world of SaaS-based solutions, it still offers some great usability and functionality when it comes to website themes that it offers that are being specifically designed for somebody building a membership website and marketing automation. When it comes to the pricing, that is where some of the weaknesses of Kajabi really show itself quite clearly. I'm going to just talk about the month-to-month plans. When you go to the Kajabi site, the pricing that they put in your upfront is the yearly pricing month-to-month, but I'm just going to concentrate on the month-to-month. They offer a free program that's time-limited, does give you the opportunity just to try the product out, but I'm just going to concentrate on the free pricing levels that come with the paid version. And month to month, that starts at $150. The thing you've got to be aware here is under the 150, you can only build out 3 products. Product, in Kajabi language, you can link products with courses. So you can only have 3 courses, which is great when you're starting out. But if you're really looking to build a real sustainable business, you're soon going to be building more than 3 courses. So the jump from the 3 course platform to the next level is $199. So I feel the medium product, because that include up to 15 products, 15 separate courses, that probably will satisfy the majority of clientele. So definitely, I think, I wouldn't say it's crippled, that would be unfair, but I think there's a strong limitation on the lower paid plan, which only allows you to build 3 products in their language. The other limitation, you can send unlimited email, but you can only have on the lower paid plan, you can only have 10,000 contacts, which does in truth cover the majority of people starting out. But if you're building out or buying or obtaining large lists, that is can be a sizable limitation. You can only have up to, this is the base paid plan, you can only have 10,000 subscribers. I don't see that as quite a limitation. The next plan up, the 199, it's 10,000 subscribers, which covers almost the majority of people, unless you've got a very large e-learning membership site. So when it comes to the lower plan, I think the crux that makes it unattractive is the limitation of 3 products, 3 courses. So the bulk of people very rapidly end up on the middle plan, which is $199 per month, unless you go for the yearly plan, and that reduces. I think you get about 25% off. I think that's the main thing that I think you really got to understand. Like I say, I've written an article that goes into a bit more detail about some other things that you've got to be aware of. But I think in this short video, I've outlined the things you really got to be aware of when you make a choice with Kajabi. Of the SaaS offering, I do, like I said at the beginning, I think apart from Podio, it is the most polished, the most fully integrated platform that has been built with a team that has a substantial knowledge of helping people build an e-learning business. I think, and I will say this, and I honestly believe it, that you should look at WordPress because of the ownership of the business platform that you get with WordPress. But I'll let you make that decision. If you found this video useful, that what you can do, please share this on your social media. That really does help my channel. And if you're feeling generous, please subscribe to the channel and you'll get a message through YouTube telling you when I put any new content, and I tend to put a lot of new content every week on this channel. So please subscribe, and like I say, please share on your social media platforms if you found this video useful. I'll see you soon, folks. Bye.